In this video, we are going to learn about DNA replicating enzyme, DNA polymerase. We will discuss these points to cover the whole video. At first, brief discovery of DNA polymerase. What is DNA polymerase? Types and structure of DNA polymerase. How does it work? And finally, roles of DNA polymerase in genetics.
In 1955, Arthur Kornberg and his colleagues were the first to identify the enzymes necessary for the DNA replication. Their work focused on bacteria because the bacterial replication machinery was assumed to be less complex than that of eukaryotes. Kornberg shared the 1959 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for his discovery of mechanisms in the biological synthesis of deoxyribonucleic acid with Severo Ochoa. Kornberg's approach was a biochemical one. He set out to identify all the ingredients needed to synthesize E. coli DNA in vitro. The first successful DNA synthesis was accomplished in a reaction mixture containing DNA fragments, a mixture of 4-deoxyribonucleoside triphosphate precursors, abbreviated as DNTP, and an E. coli extract. Kornberg used radioactively labeled DNTPs to measure the minute quantities of DNA synthesized in the reaction. Kornberg analyzed the extract and isolated an enzyme that was capable of DNA synthesis. This enzyme was originally called the Kornberg enzyme but is now called DNA polymerase 1. DNA pol 1 for short. So by definition, enzymes that catalyze DNA synthesis are called DNA polymerases. So with gradual studies on this discovery, it is found that 5 components were needed for DNA to be synthesized. The first one is all 4 DNTPs. These molecules are the precursors for the nucleotide building blocks of DNA. Next one is, of course, DNA polymerase 1 enzyme. And the third one is E. coli DNA. This DNA acted as a template, that is a molecule used to make a complementary DNA molecule in the reaction. And next one is DNA to act as a primer. Why a primer is needed in case of this reaction? Because a primer is a short DNA chain needed to start a DNA synthesis reaction. For primers, Kornberg used short pieces of DNA produced by digesting E. coli DNA with DNAs. And the last one is magnesium ions needed for optimal DNA polymerase activity. For several years after the discovery of DNA polymerase 1, scientists believed that it was the only DNA replication enzyme in E. coli. However, genetic studies disproved that hypothesis. Scientists have now identified a total of 5 DNA polymerases. Functionally, DNA polymerases 1 and DNA polymerases 3 are those polymerases which are necessary for replication, and the other polymerases types are polymerases which are involved in DNA repair. The DNA polymerases used for replication are different structurally. DNA polymerase 1 is encoded by a single gene, that is pol A, and consists of one polypeptide. The core DNA polymerase 3 contains the catalytic functions of the enzyme and consists of 3 polypeptides: alpha, encoded by the DNA E gene, epsilon, encoded by the DNA Q gene, and theta, encoded by the Hall E gene. The complete DNA polymerase 3 enzyme, called the DNA pol-3 holoenzyme, contains an additional 6 different polypeptides. All DNA polymerases from prokaryotes and eukaryotes catalyze the polymerization of nucleotide precursors into a DNA chain. At the growing end of the DNA chain, DNA polymerase catalyzes the formation of a phosphodiester bond between the 3' hydroxyl group of the deoxyribose on the last nucleotide and the 5' phosphate of the DNTP precursor. The energy for the formation of the phosphodiester bond comes from the release of two of 3 phosphates from the DNTP. The important concept here is that the lengthening DNA chain acts as a primer in the reaction, a pre-existing polynucleotide chain to which a new nucleotide can be added at the free 3' hydroxyl. The second way is at each step in lengthening the new DNA chain, DNA polymerase finds the correct precursor DNTP that can form a complementary base pair with the nucleotide on the template strand of DNA. Nucleotides are added rapidly, 850 per second in E. coli and 60 to 90 per second in human tissues culture cells. The process does not occur with 100% accuracy, but the error frequency is extremely low. The direction of synthesis of the new DNA chain is only from 5' to 3'. Both DNA polymerase 1 and DNA polymerase 3 replicate DNA in the 5' to 3' direction. Both enzymes have also 3' to 5' exonuclease activity, meaning that they can remove nucleotides from the 3' end of a DNA chain. This enzyme activity is used in error correction in a proofreading mechanism. That is, if an incorrect base is inserted by DNA polymerase, which is an event that occurs at a frequency of about 10 to the power minus 6 for both DNA polymerase 1 and DNA polymerase 3, meaning that one base in a million is incorrect. In many cases, the error is recognized immediately by the enzyme by a process resembling using a backspace or a delete key on a computer keyboard. The enzymes 3' to 5' exonuclease activity excises the erroneous nucleotide from the new strand. Then, the DNA polymerase resumes forward movement and inserts the correct nucleotide. With this proofreading, the frequency of replication errors by DNA polymerase 1 or 3 is reduced to less than 10 to the power minus 9. DNA pol 1 also has 5' to 3' exonuclease activity and can remove either DNA or RNA nucleotides from the 5' end of a nucleic acid strand. This process is important in DNA replication. That's it for today's video. Thanks for your patience. If you have any query or suggestion regarding this video, please put a comment below. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe.